I saw, you know, a lot of these Christians out there, I mean, they're really connected in with the whole Q thing. Have you noticed that?
Q and like QAnon, is that what you're saying?
Just Q. Q.
What is Q?
17.
Can you explain it to people? What does that mean?
17.
17, like the letter Q?
Uh-huh. And that means 8, and then you reduce that down to 2 and reduce it to 1. You know, it's a mystical thing.
For once, I have the exact same reaction as Joe Rogan to something happening. I don't know what any of that means. He doesn't either. He's a man who talks to people who believe in the whole Q thing. Not QAnon, mind you, Q. We don't want to offend them. But she has no idea what's happening. She's still out there, I guess, trucking along. And soon you might see her, at least if you're a subscriber to Fox Nation. They're giving a special to that woman, Roseanne, who's doing numerology live on the Joe Rogan podcast. Now, if you're not really familiar with Roseanne, she had a good show back in the 80s, and then it sort of all fell apart. And ever since then, she has gotten really into conspiracy theories. So she tweeted once, "What exactly about Q is doofus? Interested in your analysis, thanks." I don't know who that's to. I don't know what the doofus thing is, but she believes you shouldn't question Q. She also thinks that maybe asking questions about what exactly is Q is doofus isn't clear enough to her followers that she believes in this thing. So at one point, she just tweeted out WWG1WGA, one of their slogans. That's the whole tweet. All of these have been taken down since, by the way. That apparently was not clear enough. So she posted a video of herself watching a QAnon video. She could have posted a link to the video. Instead, she recorded herself watching the video. That's the Q stuff. She has other awful stuff perhaps we'll get to, but that is the woman that Fox Nation has decided desperately needs a special. Brett, what do you think?
Everything about this is like, okay, Q-mer. Like, she's so behind. She was so disconnected from the craziness of 4 or 5 years ago that two things happen. One, she discovers this all anew, but two, it's very obvious that like people in those last 5 years have been able to hone their like, you know, first entree into discussions with Roseanne Barr in a way that doesn't seem as crazy as in the last 5 years we've all come to know it is. So someone I'm sure just went up to her and was like, you know, in numerology, which is spiritual, which has roots in Judaism, where they would go through the Torah and say like the 5th letter here and the 9th letter here, and it would all come together. And it's kind of that kind of spirituality, which is so far removed from like blood sucking baby killers who are grooming children so that they can live forever under a pizza joint.
Yeah.
But she's so far beyond that. And it does this weird, like, it's like predatory thing where you get someone like Roseanne Barr, who is so completely jaded by the whole situation. She got canceled or whatever. And the same with Joe Rogan. People were like, oh, they got mad at something stupid he said, and they can't believe that they themselves would be the problem. And they obviously know that someone else is the problem. And anyone who gives them an opportunity to say that other people are the problem, they chomp at that immediately. And it renders up to all of us stupid crap like this.
You make some good points. To that I say 21. Yeah, 21 means 4. Track that, 17. Yeah. You know what you got? Bill Gates.
I know. One of my garbage person was almost going to be Candace Owens for saying that Bill Gates is going to use mosquitoes to make us allergic to meat because of an illness that's tick-borne.
No, but okay, as bad as it would be for her to give a detailed accounting of why she thinks Bill Gates is going to use mosquitoes to make us allergic to meat, from what I saw, she doesn't explain it. She just throws it out there. It doesn't merit explanation, and everybody gets where she's going. You can just reference that he's got the mosquitoes and they're gonna make you allergic to meat. We're moving on with our rundown, and I love it.
The guy who helped all but eradicate malaria, you're gonna be mad at him for doing stuff with mosquitoes?
It's madness. But anyway, I just wanna remind people in case they don't know, the issue with Roseanne Barr is not just the Q stuff. She once tweeted, "Muslim Brotherhood and Planet of the Apes had a baby equals Valerie Jarrett." a woman of color. Jesus. Mm-mm.
John.
And there's other stuff where she goes back and forth, like slamming Israel as Nazis and then attacking people for like being anti-Semitic or something. Like she's got all these conspiracy theories about Israeli mind control. But then there's a lot going on. I don't understand it any better than Joe Rogan.
With Valerie Jarrett, John, I remind you the quote from Roseanne Barr, who defended herself by saying, "I thought the bitch was white."
That would make it okay.
I thought the bitch was white.
My God,
so stupid.
It'd be a hell of a special. Okay. Oh my God, I gotta read this. In another tweet, why don't we have the tweet? She said of director of the Domestic Policy Council, Susan Rice, she described Susan Rice as a man with big swinging ape balls.
Here's the thing. If you're making a joke, you have more. If you're an established comedian a joke, I give her. She's fine. I don't really. I can only get so mad at that. She just swing and a miss on her horrible jokes. Just don't laugh at them and be like, you're bad.
I agree.
But here's what happened. I just want to say that quickly. Double standard of them saying like, oh, on the left, you always try to get us to listen to your stupid celebrities for their political opinions. That is dumb. And the next thing they do is give her a special so we can have to pay attention to her stupid political positions, which are dumb.
Yeah, and by the way, we can't get too mad at her in advance of the special. By the time comes, God only knows what she'll believe about politics. She doesn't even know.
Check out the Damage Report podcast each day, wherever you get your podcasts, whether Pocket Casts or Stitcher or iTunes. You can join me as I give you the news and stories you want with a range of co-hosts and interview guests jumping in on the fun each day. Again, that's the Damage Report, wherever you get your podcasts. And if you get them at iTunes, don't forget to rate and review. Sometimes I'll read them live on the show.